Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Status Report Highline for the 13th of April, 2018. I'm a bit late as the dev team dropped this by surprise on Friday night as I was streaming, but enough about me. Let's start off with lead producer, Eugen. All of us here are both playing and tweaking the version for the first stress test. You might be asking why it's not out yet, and how on earth are we enjoying it and not sharing that with you? Yeah, why are they not? Jeez. The current state of the build, although fun and quite consistent, is still a bit unstable. And what I mean by unstable, in the worst gunfights with large numbers of players and looting, we can still see at least up to 10 different crashes, averaging an uptime of less than an hour. We fixed about 500 bugs so far for the stress test alone, and there is about 50 left. About 10 of those are crashes that have been plaguing our most recent internal tests. The good news is that we're finally able to debug the reasons behind these, and are working on fixes as you read this. Once these fixes are confirmed and if nothing else pops up, usually does, but fingers crossed, we will evaluate the state of the build again and start with stress testing. We are as anxious as you to get this ball rolling. Now for the work invested into things that are not launching with either stress tests or the first experimental build. There are about 1,000 bugs fixed so far for experimental, and we are doing some heavy work on UI visuals and functionality to go beyond the basics needed to develop on the new engine. Jumping has got into the game with its first iteration and will be followed by climbing later as we polish animations and possible edge case where players get stuck. On the notion of having other means of movement rather than walking and running, we are still working on 0.63 vehicles and also the first helicopter iterations for internal testing. These are still heavy work in progress as vehicles, base building and several other features are still waiting for a commit. Implementation of the main game code of technology that we have mentioned a couple of times, enabling hierarchy between entities in the game. We will move on to that commit once we confirm that there are no larger issues during stress tests. Just to give you some scope, since I started using numbers over the years, we have tracked around 30,000 issues and resolved about 25,000 of them, where resolving means that some have become irrelevant on their own either due to the change of tech, or design, expired, won't fix, duplicate, as designed and other resolution types, in the chart shown on screen, for done or fixed. Part of the remaining unresolved issues is also related to post 1.0 content and features. We can see a big green chunk there which is fixed. 12,045 fixes it looks like, but of course there's still a ways to go. Hopefully they're easier to fix and we can get this stress test and experimental in our hands ASAP, because I think some peeps out there are getting a little bit hungry for some 6.3. Eugen finishes up by saying he's excited with what's to come with the first stress test and the feedback that the team can work with, and he will be trying to survive alongside us. So now let's move on to gameplay programmer Jan, who this time around is going to talk about voice communication, starting with radios. Personal radios are very easy to use. You don't need to hold the radio in your hand. It can be anywhere nearby, like in the inventory or just on the ground, and you can still use it. Other survivors nearby can also use your radio if they're close enough. To transmit on larger distances, you can use the big radio stations. Signal strength is based on the maximum distance. The closer you are to the maximum distance, the more noise you're going to hear. The same goes for the text chat. The closer you are to the max distance, the more your text message can be corrupted. So by max distance, it means the furthest distance you can be away before you lose signal. So if you're at that max distance away from the device, you're going to be more broken up, more corrupted, and people won't be able to understand or hear you at all if you're past the max distance for transmission. Public address system. We placed quite a few PAS loudspeakers across the cities of Chernarus, and now you'll finally be able to use them. PAS broadcasters can broadcast your voice to all loudspeakers in range. You just have to stand close to the broadcaster. It is also possible for multiple players to use the broadcaster at the same time. Listening players are hearing voices of the speakers from the loudspeakers based on its distance and direction. Next up, we have a couple of new screenshots for the megaphone. The megaphone is of course held in your hands and used to make your voice louder over a larger distance. Great for RP, trolling, or distraction from a bush. Myself or personally, I like to get a megaphone point blank into a fellow survivor or friend's face, specifically in Northwest Airfield. It's always a good time. Jan then goes on to say that we added and tweaked the sound filters for different types of devices. Radios still have their typical noise, but megaphones and public address systems received some nice echo effects, so you should be able to tell what device is the source of the sound. I'm pretty excited to get my hands on a working PA system, play some music, and live my lifelong dream of being a radio DJ. Yeah, I'm gonna die. And finally, let's move on to scripter Boris. Survivors, I have some news from our scripting team. I'm happy to say that the system for weapon particle effects has been finished for some time now. So here is a small sample of the quality of muzzle flashes you can expect to see in 0.63 stress test. Note that rapidly firing for a prolonged amount of time will heat up the barrel, causing continuous stream of smoke until it cools down. In later experimental updates, badly worn out weapons will tend to smoke more as more buildup collects in them, which prompts players to use the cleaning kit to avoid malfunctions. Ah yeah, finally a valid reason to use those weapon cleaning kits. The next task related to gunfights is the improvement of the bullet impact effects, including blood splats, which are meant to better visualize our advanced ballistic system. Currently, we have a simplified placeholder system implemented until the final solution is fully prepared. Ooh, I'm looking forward to those new blood splats. But that's it for this week's status report highlight. It's not a long one, but some juicy information in there and some nice screenshots. Don't forget to check out the community spotlight Bates put together of all your gorgeous community content created over the last 2 weeks. Also, there's a Q&A for the Xbox down below. I'll put it on screen now so you can pause and read it if you want, or check out the full status report yourselves for any information I may have missed. Thank you for watching. Thank you for hitting that like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. You know you want to. And I'll see you peeps next time.